Good morning, one and all. Myself Jagdish Aryan, Assistant Professor, Department of CSC, BITM, Bellary. Next, I'll start a topic called switching. This is the left out topic, the last topic in the third module, that is switching. Yeah. Already, two topics we have discussed. Error detection and correction, and the multiplexing topics we have already covered it. Next is the switching. What is switching, and why this switching is required? We'll see that. Before going to this diagram, particular diagram, just you'll see switching networks consist of a series of interlinked nodes called switches. Switches are the devices capable of creating temporary connections between two or more devices linked to the switch. In the diagram, we can observe these A, B, C, D, E, J, I, H, G, these are on the end systems. And in between, in yellow color, we can observe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are all the switches. Yeah. So in the diagram we can see the end systems as well as the switches, and these switches are acting like intermediate devices to connect different end systems. Next, we will go for the switching types. Here you can see in the switching there are three methods of dividing. There are three methods in the switching. They are circuit switching, packet switching, and message switching. Circuit switching, packet switching, and message switching. In the packet switching, once again, we have two more types under packet switching. They are datagram network and virtual circuit network. And here we have the third one is message switch network. And here, in this you can see, circuit switching, packet switching are commonly, circuit switching and packet switching are commonly used switching methods today in the technologies. Whereas, but the message passing has been phased out in general communication, but still as network application. Packet switching further divided into two subcategories, datagram networks and the virtual circuit networks. Before going to the actual circuit switching, packet switching and all, you will see what is the switching and the TCP/IP layer. There is a relationship between the switching and the TCP/IP layer. Already we know the TCP/IP is containing layers. I think you know switching at physical layer. In the switching at the physical layer, we use the circuit switching type of switching technique. Okay. Switching at physical layer, we go for making use of the circuit switching technique. Whereas switching at the data link layer, we are going to use the packet switching type of switching. Whereas switching at network layer, we are going to use the packet switching once again. And whereas at application layer, we are going to use the message switching. As I told already, message switching technique is not used in general application. It is used in some of the specific applications. So here, switching at application layer will make use of the message switching technique. First, we will see circuit switch network. What is this circuit switch network? It consists of set of switches connected by physical link. A connection between two stations is dedicated path made of one or more links. However, each connection is only one dedicated channel on each link. Each link is normally divided into n channels by using frequency division multiplexing or time division multiplexing, as already we have seen in the previous topic. Here, in this, we are going to discuss three phases of the circuit switching: efficiency, delay, and circuit switch technology in telephone network. Here we will see a circuit switch network is made of a set of switches connected by physical link, in which each link is divided into n channels. Here, circuit switch network is made of set of switches connected by physical links, in which each link is divided into n channels. In the diagram, you can observe here switches we have here, switch 1, 2, 3, and 4. And these are all the end systems. A and M are the end systems. And how they are connected? Each switch is connected with a link. And this link is containing multiplexed N channels. You can observe. Three channels are multiplexed and made as one link. And here also, here demultiplexing is applied. One link is made as three channels. So in this way, this particular technique been applied here. Okay. So here you can observe circuit switch. Here the end system A wants to communicate with the end section M. So there will be a connection, circuit established between the end system A and the end system M. Okay. So in this way, in this path, the actual communication takes place. Here, in circuit switching, the resources need to be reserved during the setup phase. Here, before making any communication in the circuit switching, the resources should be reserved. The resource remain dedicated for the entire duration of the data transfer until the TL down phase. In the diagram, you can observe, if A and M end system wants to communicate, first the reservation of the resources should be done. So here we have the resources. Here we have the resources like here. The resource is nothing but a link should be dedicated for the duration of the data transfer, and the switching devices should be ready to serve the request. So all these are the different resources required to perform the communication. Here, the resources remain dedicated for the entire duration of a data transfer until the TL down phase. There is an example here. Now you get to understand what is the meaning of circuit switching. As a trivial example,